Hello everybody, this is Bronislava for Handmade Rukodelky. In today's video, I will show you how to do bullion stitch per request of my wonderful, wonderful follower who has been following me for many, many years. Maureen, this video is dedicated to you. For this bullion stitch, I will set myself up first. I'm gonna go and crochet a couple rows of single crochet stitches. And then I will show you how to do this particular bullion stitch, okay? So just make sure that you have needed number of stitches where you will be placing your bullion stitches into, okay? And since this is a right side, I will turn around and I will make one more row of, let me go and actually do it with the beginning here with a single crochet stitch. So I will do one more row of single crochet stitches. So this is my last stitch over here. Okay. So now that you have the base, okay, you will make two chain, and then we will be working on our bullion stitches. And we, as you see, we need another tool. Let's say I'm using needle, but you can use any tool and any thickness of the hook which corresponds with the thickness of your yarn, okay? But the needle I have is a little thinner than my hook, okay? Right here, this is right here, this is a little thicker than this, okay? So now we will start working with our wraps, because you have to go and wrap yarn several times. You can wrap it 6 times, 7 times, 8 times, okay? So I will wrap it, let's say, 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all right? And I'm holding it with my thumb, okay? Now we need to push these down a little bit, because with the hook, you need to make a stitch in the next stitch, not this one, because this one corresponds with the 2 chain, okay? So you need to go in here, and we will go and, let me go and push it down a little bit and hold those stitches. So we will go in, yarn over, and pull yarn through with the hook, okay? Now make sure that when you do that, that this yarn right now, the stitch or whatever it's called, yarn over, that it doesn't go over your needle like that, or any tool that you would be using, okay? It has to go, the needle has to be over that stitch, okay? Now we will go and push the needle up and line it up with our hook. Now the hook needs to be turned down like this, and I kind of use my thumb to line it up, like make it flat. If this hook, if this little beak, this pointy thing is going to be this way, kind of facing you instead of the needle on the bottom, it will go and pull your wraps, okay? So you need to keep it down this way, all right? Now, from holding it with this thumb, you will go and hold it with this thumb and this middle finger, okay? Or any other finger, you can go and do it this way, okay? And then you will go and pull it through, make sure that that beak doesn't slip out, okay, of the position, okay? And you will pull it through all those wraps, okay? Now you have 2 loops over here, which you will finish with yarn over, and you will pull it through both loops. And that's the finished look of your bullion stitch. Let's go do it again. We'll put the needle under the hook, wrap it 6 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay. The next step, slide them down a little bit, slide the needle a little bit more, so you can go, oops, hold it with the thumb, okay. So now we need to go and make the stitch, go into the stitch over here, pull yarn through, okay. Now we will go and push. Okay, here, you see what I did right now? This yarn, I spliced it because the needle went a little bit down and then up again. So we need to fix this, okay? Has to be over the needle, and this one has to be under the needle, okay? Now, where is my, here, this is my, so now I will turn my hook down again, flatten it up against that needle, okay, change the position with my thumb and pull both through those loops, through those wraps, okay? And now I will go and finish my stitch by going through both of these. Some people actually go even through this one, okay? But I do it this way, okay? Let's do it again. Wrap it 6 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7, or 8. Okay, push this down a little bit. Hold this. Go in to the stitch from previous row. Yarn over, pull yarn through, push the needle up, line it up with the length of the hook. Okay, now turn it down. Hold them, all those wraps, pull it through the wraps, okay? And pull it through both loops. And make sure that when you pull it through those wraps, you always pull same length of the yarn, okay? Now, as you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As you see, this is for advanced crocheters, okay? Because this requires really very good dexterity, okay? It's not really for beginners. And we're gonna go and pull this all through these loops. Okay, one more there. And two loops. Okay, and now let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this is our end stitch. So I will just do a double crochet stitch right there. Okay, double crochet, because that's the height of my stitches, as you see, okay? I will turn around and I will go and do a single crochet stitches across. So I will start with single crochet stitch right here instead of chain stitch. And then over here, one, that's two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and one more at the end. Okay, one more at the end. And I will start my row again with 2 chain, and then I will go and make again my bullion stitches above these. Okay, so that's it. I hope that this is going to go and help you out if you are trying to do bullion stitch. Actually, I will be using this bullion stitch one of these days soon. I'm planning on doing something. a project, and so this is perfect. Somebody asked me to show her because she could not really understand another video, and hopefully this video is going to help you all out. And I will, no, you will see me another time.